Here's a fun witchy project. It's a piece of kyanite, which is normally black, but has been electroplated in this gorgeous blue. It's from Charmer's Gems, and they've asked me to create it for a Halloween project for a broomstick. So I've got 8 pieces of 0.8 mil copper wire. I've got my hand drill. I've got this table vise, which is a clamp I can put onto my work table. And I've masking taped the ends, so you can just put any tape on the ends, just to keep all those wires together. And what I'm going to do is twist them to create a cable. So I put one end of the wires into the hand drill, and the other end is going to be clamped into my vise. So this is just a very small little hobby vise that I can put on my table. I put the wires in there, close it shut, and that will just hold it in place. And then I twist and create this twisted cable. So that's one sort of thick piece for the handle of my broom. And now I'm going to unravel the end. I know you'll wonder why I've twisted it just to unravel it, but I'm not going to unravel the whole lot. I'm just going to unravel enough of the wires so that I can connect it to the beautiful piece of kyanite. So just undo the 8 wires and just slowly twist them in the order that they were twisted. And that way you'll be able to sort of twist enough that will be, you know, you can wrap around the piece, because each piece will be different. And that way you can sort of slot it, or the most pointy bit of it, the top end of it, into those wires. And then you can use some of them to wrap around the piece. Find those little nicks and niches that you can push the wire into to hold it and grip it. So it's each piece will obviously be completely different. So you're going to have to, you know, work out where the best way of wrapping is for your actual piece that you've got. And so I'm going to be wrapping some around from the front to the back. And then I'm going to use some of these wires to wrap around the top, to grip the top of that piece of kyanite onto this piece of cable. So you're just holding it and doing this slowly. And you can see I haven't straightened my wires out because I want it to look a bit gnarly and a bit twisted and a bit sort of witchy. So you don't have to spend hours, you know, sort of straightening up all these wires. Just wrap around, obviously not leaving big gaps, and then neaten that up. And you're just going to keep using whatever wires you have to hold this piece in place. So I need a bit more than that. That still feels a little bit wobbly, so I go with the next one down. And you can see it's all trial by error. I mean, the whole thing, each piece that you get will be slightly different. But this idea of using 8 wires, or, you know, however many you want to use, gives you the stability and security of having enough to either, you know, some to be wrapped around the stone and some to be wrapped around the top to hold it in place. So spend a bit of time doing this. I think I'm going to straighten this one out because I'm getting sort of near to the top now of the stone and I don't want it too wiggly. So here I go, just straightening that one out. And I think that will probably hold the stone in place at the top now, and then I'm just going to keep on going with the others. And you can see I'm just pushing it around, gripping it, and now I'm going to go and bring the other bits around. And you can cut some off if there's too many and you just feel it's too messy. The next thing to do is the ones that go around the stone, you want to tighten. So I'm just putting a little twist and pushing it onto the side of the stone. So that little twist takes up any of the slack and tightens it and makes it sit really, really, you know, nice and firmly around, and it grips the stone much better. So just spend your time looking at it. Always start from the back when you're doing these little twists, so you can do more twists from the back rather than the front. And then just make sure it just feels really tight and it's not secure, and it's not going to, you know, the handle's not going to fall off the top. So lots and lots of little bits of manipulation to make sure it's going to hold. Now, my twisted cable is far too long for the length of my broomstick, so I'm going to cut some off. As you can see, I'm using my DIY cutters, not my jewelry cutters for this, because I don't want to ruin the blades with something this thick. So I choose where I want to cut it. So that's the length I'm going to go for, and just neaten up the ends. And it's still a little bit thin. I still want a little bit more thickness really in that stem wire for the handle. So I'm going to cut some more 0.8 of a millimeter. So this is 20 gauge copper wire. And I'm going to wire wrap more wire around a little bit of the top. So this is extra grip, so I can cover any messy bits or any gaps that I might have created when I was securing it with the original twisted wires. So now I can just sort of be a bit neater because I've got a new piece of wire. So I'm just going to go over the original bit of wrapping, and then I'm going to come along and I'm going to do a few little swirly bits, I think, around the stem. So the other thing you can do is add some gemstones to the handle, just to make it a bit more decorative, because obviously this is a decorative piece. And you can do that by using 0.5 or 0.4, whatever wire you have to match. And just first of all, secure it around the twisted cable, pick up a gemstone, and then hold that against the twisted wire cable and keep the wire nice and tight, and wire wrap just by the stone, the little bead stone. And you can either put lots of these in place or leave a gap. I'm just going to curl my wire up a bit further. I've got a topaz, clear topaz here, so I'm going to add that bead and put that a little distance away. So I'm going to do alternate moonstone and clear topaz. So whatever beads you have to hand, basically, little gemstone beads, you might have some chips that you want to use. Anything goes. This is what we did with the bangles as well. So you're just wire wrapping them and making sure they're sitting on the front of the broom handle, because you don't want these to be behind, unless you want to encrust the whole thing with lots and lots and lots of gemstones. That's completely up to you. This is just an idea for inspiration to help you create something that's fun and decorative. So last one, no, maybe I can fit one more moonstone, I think. So I'm just moving the wire up, last moonstone coming up, and that means they're in place on the handle. They will sort of slip around a bit, so you know, when you come to do the next bit of wire wrapping around them, that's going to hold them more securely in place. So finish off the ends of the wire by either cutting them off or wrapping completely, you know, around the handle. And always make sure you've pinched the ends so there's nothing sticking out. So now we've got a row of little gemstones, and you're going to continue wrapping with this 0.8 mil wire. So going round the handle, maybe making a few little swirly decorative shapes. Make it sort of flow along the handle. So there, you know, I'm just sort of like going around, making a little spiral bit. Because the whole point of this piece is it's decorative. It's witchy, it's Halloween-y, but it's also decorative. So keep wrapping. And then when you come to one of the beads that you've secured, bring that thicker wire around the outer perimeter, and that will sort of set each one of them off. So you can just wire wrap around, and as you can see, that makes it stand out far more. And it also neatens up all the, you don't see the wrapping that you've used with a thinner gauge. It's twisted a bit, so I'm going to have to push it around again and back on. And then you'll need some more 0.8, obviously, because I've run out now, so I'm going to cut another length. And so when you're adding more wire, always add it on just under the last bead that you've secured or the last bit of wrapping you've done, and leave a bit left over, because that way you can create spirals with the ends. And then when you come to the top, this is what you do at the top. So as you come to the top, you wire wrap around and around till you get right to the top, then cut off, leaving a length of, say, an inch or so, and then make a tiny little circle or like a headpin, and then spiral around that until you come right to the top of the piece, and then flatten it down at the top and center it. And that's the top of your broom handle. So that gives you a nice ending. And there you have it. That's the witchy broom handle using the beautiful kyanite from Charmer's Gems. Thank you for watching.